reason Sonny gets a little bit bigger ovation than our established and future Hall of Fame ring announcer, The Fink.
Interesting dilemma. She certainly is looking good, that's for sure.
Taka will be involved in a semifinal matchup in the light heavyweight tournament against Ogula.
Oh, Flash, you are so funky. And his opponent, from the city of Holy Love, weighing 230 pounds, he is Flash Funk.
Certainly with Taka Michinoku with such a big task ahead of him this Monday, Jim, I've got to wonder, is it wise to take a match where he's going to be giving up a sizable amount of weight? He's going to be giving up over 45 pounds to Flash Funk, and he'll be facing Ogula just a few hours from now on Raw is War.
Well, the youngster certainly finds himself into a challenging situation, but you got those open contracts. Sometimes timing is not a gift. And Flash Funk, as Kevin Kelly mentioned, has a sizable weight advantage here, and perhaps for the first time in Flash's WWF career, he will not be the quickest man in the contest.
And I'm sure both these men, mutual respect for the other, each I know a fan of each other's high-flying skills, both having trained in Japan as well. Taka Michinoku, just 23 years old, as you said, Jim, but with a world of experience already.
Referee Earl Hebner, not to be confused with the Earl of Spencer. Well, that rascal's in some trouble, but in any event, collar elbow tie up here by Flash Funk. Nice pickup, and Taka Michinoku quickly back up to his feet there. You would think, Kevin, that as this match progresses, Flash may want to slow it down a little bit and use those more higher impact moves and his weight advantage and control the tempo.
And probably no other competitor in the World Wrestling Federation knows better what Taka can do. That would be Flash. I mean, Flash Funk emulates the style of Taka and vice versa. They are nearly mirror images of the other.
Flash with that modified armbar, trying to hyperextend the elbow. And certainly this Monday night on Raw, the semifinals. We'll find out who will be headed to D-Generation X in your house and the light heavyweight championship matchup. Oh, my! That was a real hard clothesline that knocked down Taka Michinoku. Taka's head bouncing off the canvas.
Boom!
And again, with that power advantage, Kevin Flash is able to slow it down and hurt his young competitor.
Very good strategy by Flash, as you said. Of course, too sexy Brian Christopher to take on Scott Taylor in one semifinal. Taka Michinoku to face Ogula. What about too sexy Brian Christopher? We see his, father, Jerry Lawler, more active in his career now.
Taka Michinoku with a nice drop kick. Yeah, birds of a feather, so to speak. One thing's for sure, that boy Brian Christopher certainly isn't adopted. And Taka going for the baseball slide. Flash had it well scouted, stepped out of the way, and delivered yet another high-impact blow. It seems as if Flash can remain vertical, not take any unnecessary chances, and just use that power. Oh, well, Flash took a little bit too much time coming back in.
Certainly did. Now look at Taka on top.
Taka, hurricane roll! Oh, did you see Flash? Flash's lower back just splattered on the concrete floor. Let's take one more look at this. Look at the way Flash lands.
On the top rope, hurricane rana, and you can just see all the wind come right out of the lungs of Flash Funk.
Flash was well off the protective mats on the outside, and Flash's lower back, maybe his left hip, really giving him some problems.
Protective mats is a bit of an oxymoron. I mean, that's about 1 inch of padding. You're coming down from that high and that fast. It's not going to do much to help you either way.
Flash Funk with a spinning heel kick. Got it in, buying himself some time as Flash is navigating a little bit gingerly here. Flash has slowed this thing down to a very deliberate pace. You'd think he was coached by Pat Riley with this slowdown technique. Taka's in trouble. Hard slam.
Obviously, Flash still trying to recover, still trying to shake off the impact of that maneuver outside the ring.
And Flash, a little somersault over the top on a near fall. Flash did take a chance there. And Flash now, what's he going to do here?
Come on, Flash.
First time we've seen him go upstairs.
Flash on the second rope, shoulder block. This could be it. The lateral press and Taka able to kick out. One thing about Taka Michinoku, he's a young man with great character. He truly loves being in the United States. As a matter of fact, he told me in a obviously broken English earlier that he really enjoyed his first Thanksgiving in America. And this is not a very enjoyable experience here, a version of a chicken wing.
Yeah, he's getting stretched right now by Flash Funk. You can tell Flash did not only a lot of training in Japan in the air, but also on the mats as well. Flash, a very well-schooled veteran.
Hard slam, nothing fancy. More high impact, more deliberate offense by Flash Funk. Many longtime fans of the Garden remember the legendary Tiger Mask, great Japanese star of years ago. Sort of Taka reminds us of that athlete. Flash up on top, and that big splash should do it. And Taka Michinoku shows that he will not quit.
What resiliency from that young man.
Taka really getting hammered here. Again, Flash Funk is a heavyweight. Taka Michinoku, a light heavyweight. And Taka shows his suddenness, his quickness again. And Taka upstairs, Hurricane Rana takeover. And now Taka quick for the cover, hook the leg. But again, the power of Flash Funk, too much for Taka.
Jim, almost an air of desperation from Taka. He knows he's in trouble. He's got to try to turn it around. But the momentum once again seized here by Flash.
Taka with great athleticism with a moonsault, a modified moonsault there. And Taka was reaching for the leg, couldn't neutralize the legs of Flash Funk. And the youngster all goes up and sits right down. Shall we say sayonara to the offense?
Oh, look at this.
Both men on the top rope. This is so dangerous here. Front face lock, superplex. Oh, what a superplex by Flash Funk. And, well, he's not going for the cover. I think Flash could cover Taka right now after that move. But Flash is going to go upstairs. What are we going to see here? A moonsault leg drop. Lateral press. And Flash Funk wins it here.
Sonny got that one right. Flash Funk victorious. Take another look. We'll see Flash Funk go up high on top. The moonsault leg drop. Got the three count. We thought this superplex from the top rope was going to get it done. But the combination of both moves leads Flash Funk to the win.
Look at this display of class and sportsmanship by these two athletes. Good job by both. Both still to come right here on WWF New York. The Headbangers from New Jersey. Battle the Nation of Domination.